So in today's class, we'll discuss about switch capacitor circuits. So in the video lectures, we discussed about sampling circuit, the problems in sampling circuit as charge injection, how to rectify that by doing bottom plate sampling, finally arriving at a proper switch capacitor integrator, and we made it as parasitic insensitive because some parasitics will affect the charges which is accumulated in the capacitor, so we made the circuit parasitic insensitive. In today's class, we'll see one particular technique we call it as switch capacitor technique, where we simulate, instead of using bulky resistors in integrated circuit, we'll replace this bulky resistors using this technique of switch capacitors. So when I say that, the idea is this: if you have a high value resistance, you will not use this high value resistance as such in an integrated circuit. Rather, you will replace this high value resistance using switches and capacitors. That means we are actually simulating the effect of a resistance using switches and capacitors in integrated circuits, right? Yeah. So we look at that basic circuit. So this is capacitor of capacitance C, and these are the two switches, say switch S1 and switch S2. So this is voltage V1 and this is say voltage V2. So I have how will I replace these switches? How will I realize these switches? Switches will be realized using MOSFETs, right? So we have switches here and a capacitor. The idea is to get the effect of a resistance. So we'll see how I can replace resistance values. Typically, a resistance of value more than 1 mega ohm in integrated circuits are realized using these switches and capacitors. Now, these both switches are excited using clocks. I'll mark this as phi1 and phi2, and I'll make a note here that this phi1 and phi2 are non-overlapping clocks. What is the meaning of non-overlapping? The clocks should not overlap, or the on time of the clocks should not overlap. So the idea is both the switches should not be turned on at the same time. So when one is on, the other should be off, right? So when I say non-overlapping clocks, the idea is both switches are not on at same instant. And assume that this clock is having some period. So the period of this clock is say T. The period of the clock is say T, and the frequency is expressed as F clock. The switches, the MOSFETs or the switches are triggered using clocks, and the clock frequency is marked as F clock. So the period of the clock should be equal to 1 by F clock, right? Now we will see the operation of the circuit. So how this will work? I will discuss the operation by considering both the switches are closed but not at the same time. Say your switch S1 is closed first. So first your S1 switch is closed. Now when your S1 is closed, that means your S2 should be open. Then can you tell me what is the voltage, what will be the charge across the capacitor C? if I mark that charge as say some Q1, what will be that? Yeah, C is the capacitance value multiplied by the voltage connected, which is V. So C into V1 is the charge across the capacitance when your switch S1 is closed. Similarly, when I consider switch S2 to be closed, what will be the charge? It should be C into V2. Now, say V1 and V2 are not equal, or you assume that V1 is more than V2. So in that case, so if your V1 and V2 are not equal, and we know that the switches will not be closed at the same time. So if these two are not equal, so how will I write the difference in the charges? Or say these two are not equal and switch S1 and S2 are not closed simultaneously. Then I can say a charge equal to difference between this Q1 and Q2 will be transferred from V1 to V2. Or when you have V1, V2 as non-equal values, the charge across the capacitance will be what? The difference voltage multiplied by the capacitance value. So can I write in this way? Your Q1 minus Q2, the charge transferred from V1 to V2 will be equal to Q1 minus Q2, which is C into V1 minus V2. Now if I want to write an average current, so you can see that depending on the switches turning on and off, there will be an average current here. So during your phi1 close, there will be some current from V1 to C, and during your phi2 close, depending on the potential V2, there will be some current from C to V2 or the other way, depending on the potential. Now if I want to define an average current, how will you define average current here? Yeah, if you have the fixed charges depending on your potentials V1 and V2, can I write it as Q by T, as your charge is actually the product of the current and the time factor. So can I write it as Q by T? So what is the Q here? Q is actually the difference in the voltage here. So Q is exactly C into V1 minus V2. And the time is this T, that is the duration of your clock pulse that turns your switches on. That is, your T is equal to 1 by F clock. Or can I write this as, so this is actually V1 minus V2. So what is this T by C? Dimension wise, what is this T by C? It will be a resistance. So I am just writing in place of T by C, I am replacing that with the resistance R. Or I can define this R, I will mark this as say RSC, just to know that. I can define this RSC as, what is this RSC? T by C value. So what is this T? That is a clock frequency, 1 by clock frequency. So I can write this as 1 by C into F clock. Right, so what I have done here, so I have two switches and one capacitance. Capacitance value is C, which is connected across potentials V1 and V2, where this is phi1 and this is phi2, both are non-overlapping. Now this can be equated to a resistance of value RSC. Now how is this related, these two circuit? The resistance value is equal to 1 by the capacitance what I am using here and the frequency of the clock that is used to drive the switches S1 and S2. So I have simulated the effect of a resistance using MOS switches and capacitor, and this circuit is known as switch capacitor circuit. So your resistance value can be adjusted by choosing an appropriate clock frequency. So by varying the F clock, you can tune the resistance value. Is this clear? So resistance is simulated using MOSFET switches and capacitor. So this kind of circuit we call it as switch capacitor technique. And this is widely used in integrated circuits to get the realized resistors. So if you understood this concept, can you just try this question? Using a switch capacitor technique, implement the circuit given such that the product of RC is 1 millisecond. dB frequency is approximately 159 hertz. The circuit given is this. You have a resistance and you have a capacitor here. Say this resistance is R and capacitance value is C2. This is your Vin and this is your Vout. What circuit is this? It's basically a low pass filter. The question is to implement this using switch capacitor technique. That means you should replace resistors using suitable MOS switches and capacitors, and you should decide the value of capacitance C2 and C1 depending on the given condition. What is the condition given? Your RC should be 1 millisecond. The RC constant should be 1 millisecond. So what you can do is you can assume the clock frequency as say some 100 kilohertz. So how will you implement this circuit? Yeah, so the circuit diagram will be when you change this. So this is a capacitance value of C1. This is your Vin and this is your Vout. And your capacitance C2 remains same. This is your capacitor C2. So these are the clocks 5-1 and 5-2, they are non-overlapping clocks. Now the question is, how to decide the value of these capacitors? How will you decide the value of these capacitors? Consider?
Yes, consider the second one.
That is true. So finally we will arrive at what? It is given that your RC should be equal to 1 millisecond. Can I write this as R into C2? Yeah, for your first circuit, your R into C2 should be equal to 1 millisecond. Now I am not using a physical resistance, but I am simulating this resistance using MOSFET switches and capacitors. So R can be replaced as what? Yeah, R can be replaced as 1 by C1 into F clock. That into C2 should be equal to 1 millisecond. Right. Now the clock frequency is given. So one of the capacitors should be given, otherwise you can assume. So you can assume picofarad value capacitors. So I will give the value as, you can take your C1 as some 1 picofarad. C2? Why we need to assume C2? So why we should assume only C2? Okay, that should be fine, right? I can choose C1 and C2. The condition of RC should be met. RC should be equal to 1 millisecond. So what will be your C2 value here? 100 pico. So will your RC2 will be equal to 1 millisecond now? Then it is fine. Now the capacitance value should be selected depending on like what capacitance range we can implement in an IC. So generally picofarad range should be fine. Even in femtofarad is also fine. Yeah, now we'll see. If I want to write the 3 dB frequency here, I should write what is V out by V in. What is V out by V in here? 1 by 1 plus SRC. So from this, what is your cutoff frequency? Yeah, your cutoff frequency is equal to 1 by 2 pi RC. Right. So your cutoff frequency should be equal to 159 Hz. That is what given. Right. So that depends on your R and C value. Now your RC is 1 millisecond. For your 1 millisecond, will your 3 dB frequency be 159? Yeah, so either one of the data is only required. So both data are given. Now if you look at this circuit, this switch capacitor circuit, will the circuit be sensitive to parasitics? No. What is parasitics you are asking? No, whether the circuit is sensitive to parasitics. So how will you say the circuit is sensitive to parasitics? We know that in an integrated circuit, all the nodes will be having some parasitic capacitance. So even this circuit is actually sensitive. So how to make a circuit parasitic insensitive? Yeah, you know that, right? So can you draw the parasitic insensitive switch capacitor version for this this one? Or say you have a resistance. Can you draw the parasitic insensitive version of this resistance? Yeah. So how will you get the parasitic insensitive version? Say this is your node V1 and this is V2. So how will you assign clocks? This will be phi 1. This will be phi 1 advanced. This is phi 2. This will be phi 2 advanced. So this parasitic insensitivity part we have discussed in the videos. You can refer back to the videos. So can you find the transfer function for the circuit and implement the same using switch capacitors? Find Vout by Vin. Yeah, without you use a switch capacitor circuit which is parasitic insensitive and find Vout by Vin for this. So what is your transfer function Vout by Vin here? Minus 1 by? Okay, so assuming that op amp is having an infinite open loop gain. So this will be equal to minus of feedback impedance by input impedance. That is equal to minus 1 by divided by R. Or this can be written as minus 1 by j omega into Cf into R. But how will I implement this R? One by C into some clock frequency. So I will mark this C as Ci as the input capacitor and Cf as the feedback capacitor. So I can write it all together as 1 by j omega Cf by Ci into 1 by F clock. So the ratio of capacitors will allow the designers to precisely set the gain as well as for the entire circuit, the transfer function. So you should replace the resistance using this parasitic insensitive part. So this is your So this circuit is actually an integrator. So this is another circuit. So can you, now the question is, find the transfer function and implement the circuit using switch capacitor circuit, switch capacitor technique. Can you try this? So what is the transfer function for this circuit? So how can I write V out by V in? R4 parallel R4 parallel 1 by that I know R4 parallel 1 by SC2 divided by R3 parallel 1 by SC2. So what is that final expression? R4 by R3 into So this is your gain expression. Now, what should we do? We should replace this R3 and R4 using SC technique. So when I do that, so how this expression will change? So R4 will be replaced by 1 by C in the F clock and R3 will be replaced by 1 by C. So it will be C4 and C3. So how the expression will change? Yeah, this will become C3 by C4 into 1 plus j omega into C1 will be there. In place of R3, I will be having 1 by C3 in the F clock divided by one plus again j omega into C2 into 1 by C4 into F clock. So how will I replace? Both R3 and R4 should be replaced using suitable switch capacitor circuits. You want me to do that? So this will be a circuit. So one last question. So design a switch capacitor filter with the characteristics given. So this is the characteristics of the switch capacitor filter given. Say this is your frequency